Do these buttons get mapped yet? No, they're all still broken. Okay. Hey, hey, come on over, have some fun with Crazy Taxi. Oh, I'm so tired. God, the wheels on that thing are so bouncy compared to the first game.
Oh, I think I had a chat up in the corner.
Oh, at some point. Where that big blank area is that was supposed to be comic chat or something.
Taxi 2. It's party time. Let's have some fun.
Hello. I've been working on my paper forever. And ever and ever. Everything you change is like, change it back or change it to this, and it's like, I just want to submit it. I don't want to think about it anymore. I don't want to look at the figures. I don't want to go through the statistics. I just want it to be done. Oh wait, wasn't I trying to do Crazy Pyramid? This garbage. Welcome to Crazy Taxi 2. I've been told it's crazy.
Ready?
Well, that's not a good start. It's Crazy Taxi.
Ready?
Go! I can't believe they don't have more of One Fine Day on this. That is the biggest crime of Crazy Taxi 2. Oh, why don't you boost? Does it spawn in slightly off the ground? I was hitting the brakes. I mean, it might also be the emulation, because every time you hit pause, all the shadows fly off somewhere that they're not supposed to be. Like that. Oh, they just drop in a little bit. Oh, it's like Jurassic Park Trespasser anytime a dinosaur shows up. Or literally anytime anything shows up. It's like you interact with the physics and all of a sudden it remembers it's in this physical world. Man, these are not working as crazy boosts, and I don't know what I'm not doing. I don't know why I thought, oh, I've had a long and stressful day, better place in Crazy Taxi 2. Man, they really want you to just crazy boost the entire time, don't they? Oops. I did not finish this last night. I went to bed because I hate it. Oh, God. I still hate it, by the way. But it will get done.
Ready? Go!
I don't know why the crazy boosts just don't always work. It's like one out of every three ultimately makes the cab go, and I can't tell you why. Yeah, maybe if they had more mines, that might be it. Well, that's not great.
That's the right way, huh? Burn the stake! Sign up and surrender!
I can go for some crazy bread. Get out. Oh, God damn it. Oh, is that really not in? Go! Out! Oh. Well, at least the curve's just a suggestion. How's the mimes summoning people into my car? Silently. Out. I don't know what is good time and what is not good time. It all feels like I am always behind in this. Ugh, God damn it. The only correct taxi choice. There's no Gus in this. I mean, there is. I have to unlock him. That's why I'm doing this awful mission. And then this takes forever. I'm trying to drift it around so I can just shoot out, but I can't. Oh, shit. I hate the arrow in this one. Ah! It's fine. Just throw that time on the toilet. Oh, God. You had to spin around there, too? To do this, it's literally just like, hey, do you remember where you have to crazy drift 180 degrees? The answer is no, I don't. Oh, well. God damn it. I hate this game. Hang on, how does this pop up? Oh, that's my boss saying great.
Ready?
Go! It's only 20. Oh, wait, those are remaining customers. It's the worst! It's the worst!
Ready? Go!
I don't even know if this is what unlocks, like, Gus and friends. Apparently there's another mission that you have to complete that's just called S-S, and I don't know if that is unlocked after this, and I don't know if it is full as or full of the same amount of bullshit. I don't know. I guess we'll find out. I should just download a completed save. Oh my god, get out! Just unwind with some crazy taxi too. That does not bring joy. Ugh. Boost! Oops. It's always the worst when you're trying to jump over something and then you just end up hitting them and then jumping. Oh, I don't have to turn here. You end up hitting them and then jumping anyway, and then you just jump in place instead of jumping over them.
Ready? Go!
It doesn't even, like, take that long to load by Dreamcast standards, but God, it could be way faster, and then you have to wait, and then the mime has to do the little spawn-in animation. Ah. Is there advice for this? Or is it just like, get good? Oh, goddammit. Really? Really? Are you... I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I'm only gonna have awful memories associated with Crazy Taxi 2. Just to use the bike. Okay, sure. Iceman and bike. Hot D and bike. Who's the fastest? Is it Hot D and bike? Guess we'll find out.
Ready?
I don't know who's supposed to be the fastest cabby in this. I don't even know if it's different with the bike or not. Oh god, that is... not a good noise when you boost. In fact, like, all the noises in this are not very good. Shit. Okay, it is definitely faster. I think he's probably the tank character. You're probably right. Because Gus was, and they probably... I mean, not even probably, they literally just took the loadout of the first dudes, and it's like... okay, one guy, another guy, the girl, and the old guy, in that order. So. Okay, who's the fastest in that case? Because in this, it doesn't really matter if I smash into dudes, because it is not that helpful. I'm gonna say Cinnamon, because she's the lightest. 114.8 pounds. You know they had, like, some sort of staff meeting about that. What are the weights for all the characters? Down to the decimal!
Ready? Go!
Guide has not the fastest description of every character. Well, generally, if I can get to the Burger King fair with more than a minute 33 or a minute 34, that's pretty good. Or sorry, 5 minutes 34, oop. So I don't know. I'll just be Hot D again. Okay. I won't. Like, I'm just gonna do this for a couple hours and not achieve it, but... the first run of Hot D seemed to be the best one, so we're just gonna leave it. Why don't you boost? Cool. I love video games. Go! Go! Why don't you boost? Is there, like, an invisible counter that just makes it so you can only boost when it wants you to? Like... ugh. Try Iceman. Is there like a cooldown after you boost? Like, I don't think so. I feel like I've done this before. I don't know. They're really all the same speed as long as my limiter cuts are good. They're probably not. Is that a crazy boost? Is that what we call it?
Ready?
Go. Oh my god, just boost. Do I not want to do them too quickly, one after the other, or do I not want to do the inputs too quickly?
Ready? Go!
Ah! For about a second and a half. Okay. Now it isn't doing it. I don't understand. Like, it's an issue with the first Crazy Taxi 2 for me. Like, half of them work, if that. And I'm sure it's something that I'm doing, or not doing. Damn it! It's fine, I'll just redo it. I mean, if I'm able to crazy boost on command, that would be great. Because I just cannot get it to work reliably for me.
Okay.
See, like, two-thirds of those did not do anything. Should I just, like, Google, why can't I crazy boost? If you happen to select the bicycle as your caddy's vehicle, there's an additional surprise. When you do the crazy dash from a standstill, occasionally the screen will appear in a fixed position as the bike zips away, rapidly growing smaller and smaller. A second or two later, the screen will catch up again. That sounds awful. Why would you want that?
Leave it to me.
I don't know. What if we just leave the camera back here? That's fun. CrazyTaxi.net describes it as a huge crowd pleaser. Pressing the accelerator too early after shifting the driver, I'm not pressing the trigger all the way down.
Am I right?
That's probably right. Let's see. I don't care about crazy drift, crazy stop.
Am I right?
Crazy tailspin? Oh wait, a limiter cut is different than a crazy dash? Oh, I'm so confused. Crazy dash. Tap the gear shift to drive from neutral or reverse. Okay, well, I'm at neutral because it's a console. Floor the gas. It won't work if you press it to simultaneously.
Am I right?
Apparently, this guy has come up with a way to remember how to do it correctly and time it correctly. Quickly say taxi out loud. Now the timing for the crazy dash is as follows. Once you say tack, you hit into drive, and when you hit Z, you floor the gas pedal. That doesn't... What? Taxi. 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 Ugh, God, it doesn't help at all. What is a limiter cut? How do you... Video game. This move must be done after a successful crazy... It must be done? Okay. Before your cab drops down to its normal top speed, it's a two-part move with an optional pause between each part. Oh god, I've been just writing and reading scientific stuff all day long, and my brain is fried, and when it's like, hey, what if you just read these instructions that are not explained incredibly well, and look at these diagrams, I just don't have the brain for it. Reduce the speed by unflooring the gas pedal, tap the gear shift to reverse, not more than half a second, and then put it in drive. It may be helpful to learn it this way. The unfloor gas pedal to reverse part is like when you charge Guile's sonic boom. Okay. Okay, I guess we'll find out. How long do you want to wait after crazy boosting before you do the limiter cut? God damn it. I hate you, Crazy Taxi, too! Do I just have to be in reverse longer? Is that the problem? Get out. Perfect. Let's go. Shit. God damn it. It was all lined up. I got the everything. It's just smacked into the truck. Get out. Crazy frame drops. You don't have to stay in reverse for any period of time. Interesting. Sorry, Crazy Taxi brings out the worst of me. But you don't turn around here, but you turn around the next one. Damn it! God, I hate driving in fake New York in this game as much as I hate driving in real New York. So much for that. So much for drifting in and then being completely opposite to the direction I came in. Okay, when you're doing your limiter dashes then, or whatever, limit breaks, do you feel like you're missing, like, half of them all the time? Is that just a natural function of playing this game? Oh. Not. I'm gonna take fake Gus back. Nope, don't want that. I didn't get Gus. I'm trying to get Gus. Generally maintaining a good speed. Oh.
Tear up the streets with your crazy driving.
Can I hand you the controller? Can you beat the mime? Also, is the baby carriage any good in this?
Ready?
Kill the mime in my car? Like, he doesn't make any noise. No one's gonna hear him be murdered. Go! Maybe I should just pick the cars. The bike is so squirrely. I don't think I'm ever gonna eat at Burger King now, and it's all because Crazy Taxi just ruined it for me. Did that not boost? I'm not using the rickshaw anymore. I'm just gonna be regular hot D. Well, I guess I could try the baby carriage. It's probably even worse. Fine, we'll just wait. God, I need a vacation. I've been writing so much. Every round of reviewing a paper, especially with my boss, and no offense to him, he's great, but it's like, I will show him the document and he will then revise a part that he has already revised with like massive changes or like, I don't like this part of it. You wrote this! I didn't change any of that! What? Why do we have to keep changing everything? I don't know about this. I didn't do anything to it! Maybe in biological psychiatry, which is where we're going to be submitting it, which may or may not accept it, because it's a pretty good journal. No, it's my first authored paper that I need for my thesis. My thesis progress has stalled because I've had to get this paper out the door to graduate first. Except when you submit a paper, you also have to wait at least a month or two for reviewers to tear it apart, and biological psychiatry has 5 reviewers instead of the normal 3, so who knows. God damn it. Yeah, it's toward the same goal. At some point.
Ready?
Go! Like, the agony and ecstasy of science, I swear. Stuff works and you feel on top of the world, and otherwise it's like, nothing works and all the statistics are bad and I don't know what I'm doing. I can't even play Crazy Taxi. My thesis is on the rapid on rapid acting antidepressants and the various mechanisms of action. I feel like this PhD is a mirage in the desert. Well, I have a postdoc lined up, so it better not be. That's a bad run. Yeah, a postdoc. It's like, you get your PhD, and then they think, okay, well, you've spent almost 30 years of your life in academia, but maybe you should spend a couple more in another university to hone your skills before you get your own lab, and that's what a postdoc is, essentially. I mean, I can't complain, because it's not every day that Harvard Medical School reaches out to you because of your research and then offers you a job, so not mad about it, I'm just tired of working. Do I want my own lab? I don't know what I want. I want to sleep, that's what I want. God damn it.
Ready? Go!
I mean, I like neuroscience. and have a commitment to my fellow major depressives out there who have no luck with pharmacotherapies. So, this one's for you, Twitch chat. Oh, god damn it! Why are there so many buses? Planning to take a break between graduation and Harvard. No! In a month and a half, I have to find a place to live, finish my thesis, defend my thesis, and get this paper published, and also move. Like, it's not great. It'll get done, I guess, but like, I'm just so existentially tired. Ready? Go. Is that enough time? It's gonna have to be. Technically, it's slightly more than a month and a half. I have to be there in like October or something, so.
I know.
There is no good day with Crazy Taxi 2. Also, the song is One Fine Day. Yeah, that's a good start. I should just start making save states between, like, good drop-offs and just building on one good run. Yeah, but it's like October is the start date, so ideally you're there and moved in and everything already. Something, I don't know. Why is the Crazy Taxi guy talking to me? Oh, because I dropped off files. Yeah, it takes a bit. That's a complicated thing. That is like a deadline I may or may not specifically hit, but I think as long as it's got like favorable reviews, they might bend the rules for you somewhat. It's like, if it's going to be published, and they just haven't gotten to, like, final acceptance, that's probably okay. Am I going this way? This arrow is really not helpful. Okay, well, that's the wrong direction. Since Sci-Hub. I mean, it's bioarchives, worst case, I suppose. I don't think that counts. Oh yeah, you're right, it is my Sims Online character. See, that's a good chain of them. I thought. Ah, god damn it! Throw this controller out the window. Ready? God, the amount of times I've driven over this goddamn bridge to then just smack into a bus outside of Burger King. Not Gus. It's no good. I don't care about what the Burger King is tired of or is not tired of. It is too long a day to care about what the king thinks. Jesus. Let's try the stroller. Hot D and stroller.
Tear up the streets with your crazy driving.
Some very specialized fetish porn right there. Oh, wow, it's really bad. Oh. That's how- what? Oh, it controls so badly. I guess because the wheels are at the back, but like... What?
Ready? Go!
I got it! Make the putt!
Can I boost the stroller? Oh, this can... This does not control... Like, anything! I don't know, maybe I could crazy jump. I don't want to use it again, so... Whatever.
Ready? Go!
Yes! Yeah, the four tracks in this game are fine. All four of, well, no, not all four of them. Some of them aren't that great. On boost. Boost. Okay, I think I just have to use the cab because God damn it. Fine, I'll just try it, I suppose. No, it's not, because I'm not even gonna get it on this. Just. Yeah, the bike is irritating, because you smack into something and you're just, like, done. Just gotta yell at Crazy Taxi for an hour.
Ready? Go!
This is not Hot D. Oh well. God, why are there so many? Who keeps dropping busloads of people off at the Burger King? No, they have, that's not useful, but okay. They have... are all the other ones actually shut down? Yeah, you might be right. I hate this car. It's too bouncy.
Tear up the streets with your crazy driving.
Don't talk to me. The Tower Records curse. I'm not gonna eat at Burger King anymore, so... It's all because of this game, and the negative brand perception that I have of it as a result.
I know.
Bob picking up homeless people to take them to the Burger King. Oh man, I want that one now. Can you imagine? I mean, it's literally the same kind of game concept. Come on. Boost. Oh, video games. They're bad. Wordlessly retry. Yeah, they've got to be putting them all there because screw you. This is what you get for supporting the Dreamcast in 2001. Is there a button that I could put in just for save states so I can just... No, there's not. Not in this version. Okay. I was hoping I could just... save after every decent passenger drop-off and just make a good run stitched together and then submit it to Speed Demos Archives. Hi, my name is Billy Mitchell. Welcome to my stream. That was pretty good. Also, I probably need to be crazy stopping, which I could never quite do right.
Oh.
a great position to be in. Are you gonna... You got a boost? There you go. God damn it! I'm just trying to unlock Gus. Where you go after this? Go. Boost. Boost. Why don't you boost? Oh God, you gotta turn around there. I hate you, Crazy Taxi, too. Ready? Go. I'm just gonna look into importing a save data file from something into Daemule and then just play Gus in Crazy Taxi 2 and have a bad time because it's Crazy Taxi 2. Yeah, I'm probably never gonna play this again after I get Gus and do like a round or two and think, heh heh, it's Gus. That's it. Out. Out! Kinda saw that coming from far away and did nothing. Really good at Crazy Taxi 2. What an honor. Do I turn around here? Don't talk to me. I wonder if jumping up on that bridge gets you anything. I mean, if it's like closer to this destination, probably not. This does not seem near where that bridge would have been anyway. It's a shockingly long drive. Out. That was not a turnaround. Is this a turnaround? It's not. So you're saying there's a Crazy Taxi dev door? I wish. Yeah, the post office is where I have to turn. Great. Oh, boost. Oh, God damn it! Are you kidding me? God. Duh! I just put a bus behind you. That's cool. Right out of the view of the camera. I think the offspring even put themselves in this, because now I hate them just by association, just like Burger King. Okay, so the one after FAO Schwartz, whatever that is also a turnaround. I guess the Hard Rock Cafe is the one Disney's technically. Yeah, sure. Why not?
Ready? Go!
Yeah, like, imagine the people that had to playtest this. Is anyone like, hey, yeah, like, 6 minutes is not enough. It's still Crazy Taxi, too. It's making me crazy. They probably did. Is a good time to drop them off at.
Ready? Go!
This is why taxis have gone extinct. That was good. Really? I really just want to see what the leaderboard is like after this, unless it's like there is no leaderboard. If you beat it, that's first place. Just by virtue of having done it. Pass fail. Oh, come on. There you go. Don't talk to me, passenger. Cool. That's fine. I'm a lot worse at this crazy taxi. I don't know why. Can't get good, it's Crazy Taxi 2. No one's good at Crazy Taxi 2. It's doing well until I was playing Crazy Taxi 2. God damn it! That's fine, whatever. That's not fine, however. Yeah, the GameCube controller definitely helps. Ready? Go! I mean, I've just played GameCube Crazy Taxi as Gus the entire time. And now, like, anything that controls differently just completely throws off everything. Oh, God. Possible 29 people. I don't know. I think it is just barely possible. Ready? Go. Maybe the last like three are all just mercifully put in your cab at the same time. That was good. I don't have a save state shortcut on this emulator. I don't think supports them. I'd have to go into the menu every time, so that's not an option. I mean, unless I pause between, which I guess I could. Get out! Ah! Ready? Go. Yeah, like some of the green zones are definitely a lot bigger than the marker indicates. Oh wait, you can hit drive. Or switch it into drive and then floor the accelerator, and that totally works. Instead of it being like 1, 2, 3. I don't know, maybe I've learned nothing about how this is actually performed. Probably haven't. great. So we have to turn around. Really? God, the buses in this are the worst. If it just didn't have buses, it would be so much more doable. Technically, sure, if you do the math, maybe it's like average of whatever seconds per person. But some of the fares are very close and some of the fares are really far. The math gets thrown off. Crazy Taxi, you're ruining me! It's feeling so much better, and now it's just gonna bring the depression back. Doing all this just so I could unlock a fat, hairy, middle-aged dude in a taxi cab in a game that I'm never gonna play again! I think it's the road to Gus, and Gus is apparently only unlocked after, like, a different mission in this. This isn't, I don't even think, the final Gus acquiring mission. I think there's another one that's probably equally irritating. Okay. I'm just gonna start making save states. If I get a really good time at one fair, I'm just gonna roll with it. That's like 30 seconds of my life that I don't have to waste going to Burger King again. Okay. After this is the same thing but harder. Ready? Okay, I'm just gonna download a save. You know what? I don't care. I've stopped caring about doing this correctly. How do you even download a save into Daemul? Crazy Taxi to 100% save game. Everything unlocked. I don't know. Is this a North American version? I guess, yeah. It's not worth doing, legit. It's garbage and terrible. What do you do with this DCI file? Use with interact/nexus card North America. I don't care if Gus is disappointed to me. They're disappointed in me. Oh, that's right. VMU Explorer, which I have not used in ages. Where's my VMU saved? I don't know, that's a good question. Damuel, let's find out. Let's close Crazy Taxi, because it might be in use. Documents, ROMs, and emulators. Nope. Dreamcast, Damuel. No. Is it data? No. It's not under save states. Because all these things are apparently last modified in 2017, and it makes me think it isn't that. This is a Sonic Adventure save file on here, which is not what I want. That one's also Sonic Adventure. Where's this Crazy Taxi save even located? I don't even know where it sticks this. Does it put it where the Crazy Taxi folder is? Like, that would be weird, but maybe. No. Huh. Okay, so it's not in this. Yeah, you have to use VMU Explorer and put them in the VMU itself, and I don't know where it happened to save this particular. I think it's this. Okay, this has Crazy Taxi data on it. And I saved a replay, apparently. Inadvertently. You just drag DCI files in here? No. Open VM, close VM. Here, this is what I'm looking at. Export. Open your VMU file, file import. Okay. Oh. Interesting. Where did that save go? Where did you get put? You're in downloads, but apparently a different downloads than the other one. Can't import VM file, error negative 10. Oh, okay. That's fine. Oh yeah, this is the AT&T DLC for Sonic Adventure, when I streamed all the different weird Sonic Adventure 1 DLCs. Well, that's cool, because I can't actually import this file. Do you want to overwrite it? Yes. There. Now, I guess I've overwritten my Crazy Taxi data, which is fine. I don't care. Save VM. Yes, save the changes. Close. All changes you made without saving will be lost. What I saved. Save all VM. Yes. Close. Yes. Close. What do you want to bet? It's just going to be like, all the Crazy Taxi data is corrupt. Sorry. I gotta fix those VMUs. Let's find out.
We're back. It's party time. Let's have some fun.
Probably just one, Gus. Oh, it's Gus. There he is. Oh, thank God. That's all I want. Set up my VMUs. Finally! And they put all the original characters in here that are all the same age. God, I can't believe they gave us Hot D and thought, oh, that's the same as Gus. Like, it's absolutely not. 187 pounds. Like, they gave us just the skeletal grandpa, which is not the same. Slash, God. All these people have mostly normal names, and then it's like Slash and Iceman. Gus! Oh, good. It's just regular Gus. Well, you need to know what Gus's blood type is in case he has to get a donation from you. He's 28.4 normal. I guess Gus is probably not that tall. Wait, is it not the same guy? No, it's the same voice. Oops. I think it's the same voice. I'd have to turn the music off. It sounds right to me. Yeah, it's the Gus that I remember. Oh, and just like the GameCube version, every time I play Gus, it hitches a whole bunch. So maybe it's just Gus that my computer does not want to work with, and not Crazy Taxi on the GameCube. Gus pedal all the way to the floor. See, now I like this game so much more. I don't have to deal with new weirdos. Under control. See, it's the same guy. I might have started to be warming up to Hot D, but, like, it's just a bad Gus clone. Except no substitutes. Gonna make, like, destructible fences maybe next time? Did they add more voices to Gus? I can't tell. Yeah. Also, why would you never just want to always pick up the multiple fares? They seem like they give you way more money than the single fares. In a way that, like, completely obviates the need for the individual fares. I think there's a bunch of new Gust dialogue we're missing out on. Cannot tell. God, the noise that they just make. Well, I remember how I beat that mime level after a really long time of struggling with it. Thank God that's over. That I beat legitimately. Some of the lines do seem slightly different. Hello, bus. Result, semicolon.
Game over.
Yeah, that might be it. I just want to hear only Gus. Oh, God. There was another one? Wait, first place for that? They expect you to do it 30 seconds under time? So to get first place, when I was doing that god-awful mime mission, I was like 40 seconds behind first place. There's no way!
Drive like crazy, but don't get lost.
What is this? What do they expect you to do? 33! Nope. I already don't like it. Oh, wait. Let's just have the worst of both worlds. Now we can see if Gus canonically has legs. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, look at him go! And the offspring just did not show up for this one. This is impossible to control, by the way. This is maybe the worst driving vehicle I've ever used in a video game. Also, he grunts a lot in this.
You got 25 people left.
cannot begin to explain how poorly this controls. Can I just have a model of Gus running as like a Trackmania car? I mean, the noise is kind of funny when you drop them off.
Come on, now I said that way.
I can't drift my Gus.
Yo, Bang.
Go to the university. Oh man, now that we have the Gus model with legs though, he can be in anything. I can't believe they don't have any cheats that are just like the characters running without a vehicle. I guess you could technically modify the files and just like delete it. Delete the carriage entirely or something. Make it entirely transparent. No textures. Sorry, there's no offspring.
Don't worry, relax.
Take it easy. Take me to the zoo.
Okay.
What else can
go.
Gus do? He could walk backwards really fast. Particles for the Dreamcast, actually.
Relax.
Just shooting out of one part of the tire, though.
No problem. I'll get you there.
I like how Gus barely jumps with this and he just pulls his arm up and lifts it.
It's under control.
It's great. Picks up the baby carriage with his left hand. It's under control, don't worry. I forgot to shift Gus. Yeah. I forgot to shift Gus into drive. I cannot even begin to explain how poorly that controls. How do you pick the different... Wait, what does that map option do?
Go ahead and pick a car and driver.
Oh. Oh, you just hold it.
Gus.
Okay, let's have some fun.
Well, it sounds the same. The GameCube version loads way faster. I guess it's got those tiny little discs. Less room for the laser to travel.
Hey, it's time to make some crazy money. Are you ready? Here we go!
Just want to hear the voices. Make sure it's the same.
Yo, you're styled. Can you take me to the stadium?
Okay.
Or if there's new Gus content I'm missing out on. I think it's all the same. All the same. Did they record new Gus for Crazy Taxi 2? And then they just put him in the GameCube version? Or was new Gus already in like the home port of the Dreamcast version? That sounded slightly different. I don't know, some of them are maybe slightly deeper.
No problem.
I'd have to bust out my own copy of Crazy Taxi at home and find out. Was it only Gus that was re-recorded? Also, how old was Gus again? Did it say he was 42? I have to go back to that menu. I don't think that's right.
Go that way.
Don't worry, relax.
Oh no, is he actually? Well, I suppose 14 divorces will do that to a man. Gus, as your doctor, you have to stop eating exclusively hot dogs. Look what it's doing to you. You're 42. You have the body of a 70-year-old man. Look at Hot D.
Hey, are you trying to hit me?
You're not hurt. Get in.
That's what you should aspire to.
Okay, here we go.
Go that way.
It's under control.
He's like 100 pounds. Like a pharaoh's mummy they dug up and stuck in a cab.
Move it, move it. Wow. Yeah.
It does feel slightly different in pitch, but I can't tell unless I have them side by side, I think. Oh, no, he does have some new lines. I think.
Yo, wait up! Don't refuse me! Watch him!
What are you doing? Do you
stop
talking,
man? Stop it.
I want to go first.
Hey,
no,
speak English.
You shouldn't have to tell a bunch of mimes to stop talking. Oops.
Just sit back and relax.
I thought they were just mimes, but who can tell anymore? There's something very weird about how they all have, like, radically different voices. Because you pick up the mimes and they all make that weird high-pitched mime noise. And then sometimes it's just like the dude from the original game just yelling, "Go straight!" Oh, it says, "See you guys." This is Crazy Taxi 2 on the Dreamcast. Now with Gus.
Let's go, guys!
Well, he's killed. Only 777. Well, I don't enjoy playing this one more than the original.
You better try it again.
Unfortunately. Oh, those menu lines are not right. What does map do? Oh, it's just the map. We're shooting lasers at everyone. Oh. Oh, it's literally just the map. Are these all the original voices from the first Crazy Taxi? I can't believe, maybe that says 92 and we're just reading it wrong. See, now that I just look at Hot D, now that I've gotten Gus, it just makes me feel bad. It's like, you think you could have pulled this one over on us? You think we would have accepted Hot D when we could have had Gus?
Let's have some fun.
I'm not in denial. I'm ready to have some fun. Maybe.
Hey, it's time to make some crazy money. Are you ready? Here we go!
It also doesn't start with ya, 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 so, like, everything's topsy-turvy. I guess it's pretty much all the same voices, except they've now given Gus lines for, like, oh, just one of you at a time. For the new mechanic in this. Holy botch that. It's not the same.
Hey, it's time to make some crazy money. Are you ready?
Well, it's the Dreamcast version, so I don't know how much has been modded. Or if anyone has bothered. You do that other map. That's a lot more enjoyable to drive in. Anyway, the mod for putting in whatever that Offspring song is, All I Want, that's just called, like, turning the audio in-game off and then plugging in some other audio source. Speedy, the stadium. This map is just categorically not as fun to play as the first Crazy Taxi map, which they got, like, perfectly, I think. At least the first half. The rest of it, I don't know. Although I do love the idea that when they were making a Crazy Taxi 2, Sega's like, no, it has to have the Offspring in it. It's gonna have to sound exactly like that first game. That's just what Crazy Taxi is. It's under control. Well. Speedy, the art museum. Oh yeah, no, Crazy Taxi is just a complicated visualizer for Offspring tracks. Where are you going? The station. That doesn't really clarify. I trust you. It's a weird thing to say to a cabbie. I know I won't be killed in this cab. Okay, I guess. Oops. It's like Ralph Wiggum says it. Well, I think they've eliminated the thing where you get caught on the side and just make $30 because your cab is just propped up against the wall. Where am I going? Oh, that's right. It's kind of that awful loop I have to do. Didn't I just pick somebody up from the basketball court? I'm gonna start saying that when I get into my own car. In addition to the normal things that I say to my car as I drive it. well, quote unquote normal. Is such a thing ever were normal? It controls weirdly, and I don't know what is wrong with it. It's like similar enough, but also slightly off in a way that just feels distracting, and I end up missing a bunch of stops that I think I could slide into, and I just don't. Oops. To jump, but I guess it was fine. Like that. Maybe that was... I don't know. Is there like a group of dudes? I still find it really weird that they bother to put this path up here and no one is even here. Like, it makes so much sense to put one of those long green fairs up here, but instead there's just nothing. Second VMU. It's not lined up right. Which was it? Is it this? No. That's port 0. Where's port 1? It's an internet option because it had a high score feature, I guess. What is that blue line underneath it? Thank God they put him back in this. If they made a Gusless Crazy Taxi 2, I would not be impressed.
Hey, it's time to make some crazy money. Are you ready? Here we go.
They should have put all the first city in this as well.
Yo, right here. Good job.
Oh, that's weird. That dude's body was in the first game, but he never had that head. Fake NJ transit buses. It's not going great. I mean, I guess at that point, you might as well just be playing Crazy Taxi 1. Why doesn't Crazy Taxi 2 have the maps and the characters from Crazy Taxi 1? I understand that maybe obviating the need to buy the first Crazy Taxi at that point. Yeah, that doesn't get you money anymore when you're sideways. Well, like, I have to scroll through a lot more characters now to pick Gus, which is, I mean, a downgrade. Gotta take the cheerleaders to the heliport, which is also here for some reason.
Thank you.
maybe not the most direct path I could. Oh. Wasn't there a stop over here that I was really close to? Oh. The law court. As opposed to the food court. Under control. Oops. There you go. You gonna pay me for that? No? Okay. Is there anything in the ocean? No. Not really. Why are there no fairs underwater? What? What'd I do wrong? I mean, I know they count as one. Let me see. Is Crazy Taxi 2 an arcade game? No, it was not. It's ported to the PSP as part of Crazy Taxi Fair Wars. The Dreamcast was discontinued March 31st, and Crazy Taxi 2 came out at the end of May. That's sort of disappointing. People making this game are like, well, it's a doomed console, but we have to put these other not Gus's in it. It saw the introduction of the Crazy Hop feature. Wow. The sequel includes a modified soundtrack with Rock Band's The Offspring and Methods of Mayhem. Never heard of that. The game also has, according to the Wikipedia article, parentheses, some online modes in the form of a scoreboard and replay sharing. Great. I mean, the reviews are good. Next Generation Magazine gave it 3 stars and said, if you like the original, and who didn't, there's just as much to like here. 3 out of 5. What? Who didn't like this game? 3 stars. 60%. Crazy Taxi Fair Wars, the PSP port of Crazy Taxi 1 and 2, was also released in Japan called Crazy Taxi Double Punch. Apparently, according to Wikipedia, this does not seem very unbiased, it has downgraded graphics, a lower frame rate, and a worse control scheme. The game's developers noted difficulty in porting the games to such limiting hardware. Did they? You're just making that up. God, there's just a whole paragraph. The studio initially chose to work on Crazy Taxi because they believed the series had quote-unquote near-perfect gameplay and wanted to make a true port, believing that the PSP would quote-unquote make a lot of sense. They also considered multiplayer something they would give the game, or that would give the game a quote-unquote new feel. Okay. Oh, I guess it's the postmortem from Kama Sutra. Maybe I'll read that. Maybe I'll read that before bed, which is where I'm gonna go now. Okay, bye!